Hello, it's Scott Manley here, and today I am looking at Pioneer, which is a fan reimagining or reimplementation of the classic Frontier. Well, it's a classic, I say it. Frontier was a sequel to the undeniably classic Elite, and Frontier was more famous for its vast scope, trying to cover an entire galaxy. Indeed, if I click around, well, what have we got here for options? Well, let's take a look. We are currently on the planet New Hope. And all these buttons do different things. Let's take a look at the map. Aha, yes, bring it into map mode. And we have a whole galactic map, which you can explore if you want. But this actually lets you zoom all the way down. And I can zoom all the way out. We have all these stars. Anything near the planet Earth is more or less implemented from catalogs, and as you go further out, you start to get into procedurally generated content. If I just scroll out and I say draw label out of range systems, you see that it suddenly comes into a whole bunch of imaginary names. Now, there will be actual systems as you go further out, because there are brighter stars that are easier to, that we have good distances on, whereas in our backyard we tend to only have those ones which are covered by the catalogs and things like that. I wonder, actually, let's see if Rigel is in the catalog. Rigel, it's not finding it. It's thinking not found. Okay, so there we go. It doesn't, it's only really looking nearby right now. In the original Frontier Elite 2, you would have some of the stars that were further out. So anyway, I'm in Epsilon Eridani. And so here we are. We have a bunch of stuff nearby. Now, the point of all this is trading, making money, advancing, you know, expanding your horizons. So let's take a look. We have all these different planets. We have Icarus, a rocky planet with an argon atmosphere. Atlantica, massive planet with some ice in a very dense oxygen environment. New Hope, it's an ice world with a carbon monoxide and a high... Wow, that's an interesting. Has an ecosystem that lives off carbon monoxide. And Eagle's Nest, orbital starport. I mean, actually, carbon monoxide can act as an oxidizer because it will oxidize to carbon dioxide. So anyway, if I look at the economic, it tells me that major exports are liquid oxygen, fruit and vegetables, liqueur, and grain, or liquor. Yes. So I want to find a place nearby where I can take that. So let's go back to this and... what am I looking for? Well, Sirius. Let's try Sirius, which is nearby. And of course, Sirius has a star, a bright, hot star, and a white dwarf, a compact remnant. But let's check the economic info. Aha! Major imports! Liquor! So I can take a bunch of alcohol here and sell it, hopefully for some sort of a profit. So let's talk to the local starport. Let's see. Oh my goodness! Oh wow, yes, this game has some of the ugliest characters you have ever seen in it. But nevertheless, we shall, let's not mock it too much, because the game does actually improve on Frontier in many ways. And in fact, I mean, the avatars in this are a huge improvement on Frontier, but then again, Frontier was a 16-bit game. Okay, so I've loaded up my spacecraft with as much alcohol as it can carry. Let's take a look at my spacecraft here. It has a Class 2 hyperdrive. It is a wave-heavy hypersonic fighter with a 1-megawatt pulse cannon. It's, okay, it has a bunch of fuel on it. And, yeah, I don't know. Let's see. Oh, and this is my character. Rating harmless. Let's change this to an appropriate name. Jameson. Let's call them Whiskey Jameson. There we go. Not that I drink Jameson very often, but it's an option. So let's toggle male, female. Let's hit random. I'm sorry, I can't stop. Oh gosh. I think some of these guys look like they've been hit by a bottle of Jameson. I'm sure these are the faces of the developers. I hope you guys aren't too offended. I really love the aesthetic. It's like, it's almost purposely bad. Okay, so let's go to the actual... what else can we do? We can request a launch. There's also a bulletin board. Maybe there's somebody that will that wants us to go to Sirius. Oh, look, so you can deliver packages to these various locations. I'm not going to any of these. And actually, look at some of these. Passage for a small group. Deliver a small package to Eridani Commercial Center. Hmm, that's interesting. 25 credits. How far away is that? I could just do that within the same systems. When must it be delivered? By 8th of January. Why so much money? I don't think it's a lot. Will there be any danger? No. Could you repeat the original request? I will pay 25 credits for a ship to deliver this package to Eridani Commercial Center. Okay, agreed. Hang up. Excellent. Let me do this. Let me get into space. Request a launch. And so there, we take off. Now, if I press F5 and activate the autopilot, also bring my gear up. Now, the way this works, it is a full Newtonian system. I can set a speed, and you'll hear the engines firing as it tries to turn around to activate these things. Now, I can put it into manual mode. Look, there's a nice big spaceship there. I should probably clear out of here, but let's fire the lateral thrusters. Oh, crikey. Oh, that was not good. No, I probably shouldn't have done that. Where's the button for vertical thrust? That's it, yes. Ah, okay. Set my speed to zero. Okay, now we'll hover. Uh-oh, where are we looking? There, we're hovering over this thing now. There, look, my spacecraft is just like gonna hold its position manually because I've told it to. There, and I can press the lateral thrusters to fire, the vertical thrusters. Actually, you can see what's going on if I switch to external view and zoom in here. Whoop. So you can see the engines firing. I can't believe I crashed, like, right away. Fly safe, guys, huh? So by pressing... yeah, pressing I, I'm going to go upwards. I pushes me forwards, and the acceleration on this thing is blistering. It's like insanely high acceleration. If I go back to inside view, oh yeah, it's now going to slow down completely. If I press F1 to go inside and rotate. Now I can press F5 to disable manual control, and now just hold the button to accelerate. Now this is me thrusting as if I'm using the translation thrusters on a Kerbal, you know, on like RCS translation thrusters. So there, I'm accelerating upwards, and you see already that I'm moving at about 1.8 kilometers per second. So this is accelerating at about 10 G inside the atmosphere. This is a base spacecraft. It is not the fastest thing. Of course, most of this stuff you're not really going to be... you're not really going to be relying on your manual flight, but you can do it. Also, you can accelerate in reverse, because these things have thrusters on every single side. Oh, no. Gotta remember to move. Oh, yes. That's not good. Oh, yes, I should probably press F5 for manual control. Actually, let's just... where was I supposed to go? I need to remember what the mission was. Let's go to the mission. Whiskey Jameson, nope. Julian Buckley, deliver to Eridani Commercial Center. Okay, so let's go and get on the comms. Eridani Commercial Center. Autopilot, dock with the space station. There we go. So now it's going to do all the flying for me. And there we go, inside. It's going to do all the flying for me and get me there ASAP. But of course, that could take a certain amount of time, so I can time accelerate, and it will do all the flying for me, and we can admire this planet, which is of course vastly improved over the kind of graphics you would have expected on the original game. The original game was, well, I originally bought it from my Atari ST, which was a 16-bit system. It had a whole 1 megabyte of memory, but even then it loaded everything into memory. It didn't load anything off of disk. that it came on one floppy, if I remember correctly, didn't have any hard disk or anything to install, and 8 megahertz. So yeah, it was quite compact for its age, and it included an entire galaxy. Of course, it was all procedurally generated out to a certain, once you got beyond a certain distance. Look, so my spacecraft is of course flipped around and is doing braking operations, but I'm docking. All the docking is happening all on its own. Yes, there we go. Oh look, there's somebody parked over there. Thank you, your package has been delivered. You've been paid in full. I wonder what it's going to take to fix my ship. Repairs and servicing. Repair 1% of hull damage is going to cost 93. Oh, this is hilarious. I've completely trashed my spacecraft almost immediately. Wow, wait! Lisa Armstrong, your avatar does not look absolutely hideously ugly. Congratulations, you are the most beautiful character so far in this game. Well, I'm just going to request launch. Let's check the bulletin board. Time and Space Engines Incorporated. Lisa, where am I? I'm going to go to Sirius, right? Better make sure. Set my hyperspace is set for Sirius, so I'm just going to request launch and off we'll go. We shall hyperspace across the galaxy. There, we'll fly out of the space station. Let's press F1 to view the rear view. So let's turn this around so we can actually see the space station. And we're now on manual control, so it will translate for me. If I do my second travel up and down just manually here. See that? Oh, excellent. I should probably bring all my landing gears already in. I can bring my landing gear down if I like. I can bring it down. Okay. There. Oh, landing gear. All the ships have landing gear, and you can actually have your landing gear destroyed. Anyway, we are here. We're going to hyperspace. Let's view from the front point. Hyperspace! And there we are! A day later, we are in the Sirius system, so there's only one place we can go to. Well, wherever you go, it will be the Wong place. Autopilot dock with the space station, it will of course fly off, and I can just hit this button, and it will travel at ridiculous speeds. It does the whole thing, the acceleration in a suicide burn. It flies around along at about 10G, I think. Let me just see, what does it say? Does it have actually atmospheric shield? It doesn't tell you how fast it accelerates. The old manuals for this game would have all this detail. They would show you all the information you ever wanted to know. There we go, look. You can see we're coming in backwards very quickly. Whoa, look at that. Awesome, Wong base. I should probably adjust everything to get myself viewed correctly. So I mean, you know, one of the reasons I'm showing this is because really nobody seems to be hearing much about the Elite Dangerous Kickstarter. That, well, I mean, truthfully, they haven't been telling us very much, but I've been wanting to give it a mention since I put £100 into it. Like, I put £100 into it. That's like $160 right now or something, you know, ridiculous. It's actually, when I started backing Star Citizen, I only put down like $40, so, you know, it's kind of gone the other way, that I now have more money in Star Citizen than I have in this, because there hasn't been much to see about it. You can still back it, and it's definitely a hugely ambitious project. Okay, so I'm going to sell my liquor for not much. This, 137, so I did not make so much for major imports. Man, I've really messed myself up, haven't I? Let's take a look at what can I take a look at? Well, I should probably go to the shipyard. No, I'm not going to do that. Let's go back. Commodities, let's buy some hydrogen, because hydrogen is used for hyperspace fuel and things like that. Let's go and take a look at the maps. Okay, where can I go? First of all, what's the major exports here? We export military fuel here. I wonder if I can even afford that. Commodities market. Military fuel. I can buy a I can buy a couple of units of that. Great. What else can I buy? Consumer goods. Who would have an import of military fuel? Let's try looking for Saul. What does Saul say? Economic info, mining machinery. Not a place that I want to go. I wish I could easily find a place where I could export my stuff to. I should probably have not bought something until I knew what I was exporting. Captain's Star, heavy industry. No. Not a good place. Oh, I gotta find a base, don't I? Procyon, where's that? Extensive mining operations. Economic, carbon ore. Why did I buy military fuel before I knew where I was going to take it? That is a very silly idea. HD from the Henry Draper catalog. No registered settlements. Mining colony. Stable system. These guys import not very much. What was the awesome stuff that we have here? I gotta move the cursor around. I gotta go back to check what this thing has. Major exports, consumer goods, medicines, liquid oxygen, military fuel. So I'm looking for a place that will buy these things. Label out of range. Oh, actually, I'm gonna turn off the labeling of out of range systems. Epsilon Eridani. Oh, I already started there, didn't I? I'm at Sirius. Lalande, heavy industry. What do you like here? Major imports, not good. I'm gonna leave the economic. This is gonna take some time. Maybe, you know what? Screw this. What I'm gonna go is commodities. I'm gonna sell that stuff back, right? I'm gonna sell the military fuel back because I'm not gonna be able to make any money off it. I'm gonna go to the bulletin board and just carry stuff to people. So once you get the larger ships, you can actually buy crew. Wong Base Engine Servicing Company. Avoid the inconvenience. Yeah, service up my hyperdrive engine. No thanks. Not what I'm needing. Let's see what else. Can I donate to war orphans support? Nope. Money paid for delivery to a small package. 957. There we go. Why so much money? Left behind some clothes and antique paper books. I'd like to have them returned to it. It must be delivered by the 14th of March. I highly doubt. Okay, I like that. They're going to pay me 900. Wait a second. Could you repeat the original? 957. Okay, I'm going to do this. A distance of 26.7 light years. Okay, hang up. So I might have to travel a little further than I expected. And now I'm going to look for the thing, and I've completely forgotten the code already because it'll be under here. NN3275. This UI could use a bit of work. 32. No, I'm not clicking on you. I'm searching for it. 275. Okay. Maybe I need to do the full thing. NN. 3275. Not found! Excellent! Let's zoom back in then. Nope, gotta zoom in. Okay. How do I find the place that I was supposed to go? Search. Ah, there it is now. Is it within range? It does look like it's in range. Excellent! Some established mining. What do they import here? Economic import. They're importing. Oh, liquid oxygen. That's exported from Syria, so I'm going to take that and sell it over there. Okay, so let's go to the commodities market and buy some liquid oxygen. Liquid oxygen. Where is it? Oh, there it is, right at the start. Bye. Okay, my ship is fully laden and ready to leave. Request launch. Now let's try and do it properly this time. Oh, there, this one. I can actually just fire this myself. See that? And let's bring up the landing gear. We can view the landing gear coming in. Beautiful. Actually, let's bring this back and start firing forwards. Hey, look at that. So now my engines are firing full throttle. There we go. Once we get high enough, we should be able to fire our hyperdrive. We are moving like 2 kilometers per second. Yeah, Wong base. Sidereal view. I guess that rotates with me. ON3472. I wonder if this they've implemented unique serial numbers in the hull. I believe that there was a version where it had the numbers turned up in the hull, but I could be wrong here. Okay, let's hyperspace. Yeah, we're going ludicrous speed, and you see this takes a while because it's going to take an entire week to jump this whole distance. That was the standard, I believe, that it takes 1 week or thereabouts to travel the whole hyperspace. Maybe it's a month, because this is taking a long time. There we are. That was practically a month to go that far. Okay, 1 AU, or maybe it was 1 AU per day. That's more like it. Oh, or one, not 1 AU, 1 light year per day. So, where are we going? Are we going to Ray or Juarez? Let's find out. We're gonna go to Ray. Hey Ray, how you doing, Ray? Chin's mine. So we can, of course, activate this. And off we go. Now you could fly this manually, but no, I'm not gonna fly it manually. One thing I never checked actually was the security status of this system. I should probably do it. What does it say? Demographics, government type, mixed democracies. This is Allegiance is the Confederation of Independent Systems. Social democracy. It doesn't tell you the security thing, does it? Planetary info, economic info, demographics. In the old games, I mean, there is combat in this. The guns aren't set up to fire right now, but no doubt. I'm presuming as I fly out further, I will. Uh-oh, what was that? Was that another target? Was that a target? Or am I going the wrong way? Am I looking out the front of my spacecraft? What? Oh, there we go. Is this thing trying to rendezvous with me? Is that what he's trying to do? This thing that's flying around. I have no idea. It's not my friend. I don't know what that is. Maybe it's just another spacecraft that's just followed me through. I mean, after all, it's a pretty expensive amount of cash I was paid. I wouldn't be surprised if for 1,000 credits there was something in those antiques that was worth being attacking me over. Okay, so I've actually made some decent cash now, but let's go to the commodities market and hopefully I don't think I made any money on the liquid oxygen, to be honest. Okay, let's buy some hydrogen fuel anyway. Cash, 1,000, excellent. Let's look at the bulletin board. The bulletin board appears to be the better plan. Deliver documents to the TZ Aratus system. Experienced pilot. Will I be in any danger? It could be dangerous. You should make sure you're adequately prepared. Excellent, because I want to die. I have some extremely sensitive documents that have fallen to my hands, and I have reason to believe the leak has been traced to me. Wait, okay. Presumably your hands are no less deformed than your face. I must be delivered by this date. Will there be any danger? Okay, I'm gonna do this. Okay, agreed. Cause dying would be an awesome thing to happen. Hang up. Excellent. So now, we need to get ourselves, and I gotta look at my thing here. I've got a rubbish laser, a damaged ship. How bad could it be? TZ Aratus. TZ Aratus. Time zone. Time. Aratus. Is that it? Not found. Let's see if I search for that. Will it find? TZ Aratus, okay. I hope this isn't out of range. It's well within range. Excellent. I'm just going to go there and watch myself die. Because we all know that somebody is coming after these documents. So what better way to bow out from this than to get attacked? Now, of course, you can spend a lot of time upgrading your ship and everything like that. I'm just going to accelerate forwards. So go even faster. Leave this thing behind. There we go. Look at that. That's my old friend Ray. Now we're going to hyperspace. I should probably bring in my undercarriage before doing that. Ooh, hyperspace. Yeah, I think it must be that every day in hyperspace is like one AU. Or one light year. Darn it, I'm just absolutely terrible. Okay, can we do this? Now we're going to go to Feng platform. I remember this time. Docket Space Station. Excellent. Now let's see if we can get through this without being attacked. Front camera. Now we're coming the other way. I'm wondering if this is a bad guy or a good guy or something. I don't know how to read this thing. But I'm going fast. Look at this. 7,000 kilometers per second. Ship velocity by reference object. Ah, look, I totally made it there! Haha! Darn, and here's me thinking I was going to get into a fight. I really wanted to get into a fight. Your timely and discreet service is much appreciated. You have been paid in full. Commodities, gotta buy some more hydrogen. Wow! Oh, Miriam! Oh my god! Oh, commodities, more. Oh, let's go and see what the bulletin board says. Nearby, a quick delivery to Maynardville. What is that? Your faces would be great if it wasn't for that. They look like shot glasses or something stuck on your head. I highly doubt it. Okay, agreed. Hang on. Maynardville, what else? Interstellar removal. So you could. There's also assassination missions. Documents to the NN357. Delivery of a document. That's pretty boring. But that would take me to Proxima Centauri. Hang up. Let's find one that will more dangerous. NN34. Will there be any danger? It could be dangerous. Okay, agreed. Hang up. Right, so I've got two missions. First one is to Maynardville, and the second one is to Mayo's coming to kill my ship. There we go. Front, and then we're going to rotate around and fly out. Let's take a look. Ah, there we go. Look, can I bring up my undercarriage while I'm still leaving? Not yet. Apparently, bringing the undercarriage in this early is not permitted. There we go. Bring that in. Maynardville. Is that like Margaritaville? Or Marwanaville? No, never mind. Let's take a look at different viewpoints. What does this system look like, actually? Because I didn't really look. We have it's a Type M red star, which, yeah, Star Trek people, Type M refers to a star, not the planet. And Vice platform, and this one has Maynardville. It is a tiny rocket planet with no significant atmosphere. Excellent. Well, just go to front view again and fast. Where are we? Front view, or is that rear view? I don't know. Look at that. It looks kind of like Mars, doesn't it? So now we have to fly around the planet, and what's interesting is we are traveling around the planet so fast that we must be exceeding orbital velocity because the engines are all firing down to keep us closer to the planet. That's one of those challenges I always wanted to do in Kerbal Space Program. See how fast I could go around the planet? Because, of course, to go faster than about 2.3 3 kilometers per second, you need to actually fire engines downwards, right, to keep you close to the surface. Okay, this is traveling at 100 times normal, or 10 times normal speed, and it's just ain't letting me. Maynardville, there we go. And there's a hyperspace departure cloud. Now later on, you if you get your ship all set up, the idea is that when a ship jumps out, it leaves like a hyperspace departure cloud remnant behind. And if you want to be a bounty hunter, you can follow these targets as they jump into hyperspace and then kill them as they come out in the other end. Now the other option is that you basically kill them as they leave the spaceports, and of course if you do something like that, then the police get really mad at you and they shoot at you right there. So if you want to be like a proper bounty hunter, you basically wait until they've jumped into hyperspace, you follow them, and of course using your military grade hyperdrive, you get there before them and assassinate them in deep space. Okay, so now we've got that, now we're gonna request launch. Whoa! Oh, wow! I think the best part about this is the portraits. And... oh, yes. Okay, let's request launch. Oh, no, I gotta find out where I'm going, don't I? I am going to... NN3417. NN3417. Excellent! There we go. Let us request launch. Aha! Look at that. We'll go and we'll fly forwards again. I can fly with the keyboard as well if I like. Let's turn this camera around so I can see the ground receding away from me at ridiculous speeds. Maynardville, possibly named after John Maynard Keynes. Economist who, well, he was a big fan of what's the thing? Government stimulus to smooth out an economy, to avoid the boom-bust cycle. It was pretty important as economists go, but economics isn't necessarily the best science. Okay, isn't necessarily the most accurate of sciences. I should probably bring in my gear. Hyperspace! Actually, I kind of like the bullet time hyperspace effect. It's surprisingly cool, especially when the camera is moving like this. Whoa! Come out the other end. Okay, where does I need to get to? Mayo Outpost! Let's see if I can get there without getting attacked. Because I'd like to see some bad guys so I can actually shoot them. It would be nice if I didn't have to actually attack, like, the police or whatever. Okay. Full speed ahead! Towards Kelly's misery. Is Kelly, like, you know, the girlfriend of one of the developers? Be kind of amusing if it was. Like, oh, you never spend time with me, you're just coding that game. I don't know anything about the developers, but I totally respect that they're doing this because I'm such a fan of the original Elite games. The thing is, the original Elite in many ways was much more playable than Frontier. Frontier was a magnificent technical achievement, but the original Elite was, the combat was actually pretty good. If you ask me. Okay, have we completed this? Yes, we've completed the mission. We actually have some money. I don't know what I'm supposed to do here. Let's go in and we'll save the game. And Mayo. I say Mayo. Gonna lift off and gonna see if the police will attack me. Let's try that. I'm gonna come out and I'm gonna turn around. This seems to be taking... I'm paused. There we go. Let's do a little bit of time acceleration, get out. Ah, there we go. Okay. So now if I hit F5, let's bring in the landing gear. And we'll slow down, turn around, and start attacking them. Yes! There we go. We get some police, maybe. Ooh, police. Where are the police? I'm gonna fly this manually and see if I can actually find... Oh. No. Not good. Okay, the police. Wait, where are the police? Oh, there they go. Oh my goodness. Where's the police? I'm just gonna be... Wait a second. Where is he? Ah! Darn, I get completely blown up. So yes, combat does actually happen in the game. But apparently right now, I guess I was in the wrong place all the time. Ah, there we go. R.I.P. Old Beaten. So yeah, I think now I've managed to successfully destroy my ship. It's time to get going. So, game is Pioneer. It's available for free. Builds are happening regularly. And yeah, I'm Scott Manley. Fly safe.